Hey there, everyone. This is John from Jane and the product team, and I'm here to show you a new chart part that we've been working on. It is very similar to our dropdowns, our checkboxes, as well as our sliders. It's a little bit all combined, but it has a lot more power to it, and it condenses quite a bit of your information into a smaller piece. We have some set up in our demo site right here, so I'll just grab one to show you an example of it. Let's grab our subjective measures here. In Jane, what we're now allowing you to do is set up a list of subjects or one subject, and then set up a list of choices to go along with those subjects. So here I have the last session, yesterday and today. Those are my subjects. And then I have the choices, which are going to be all the same for those subjects across the bottom here. So if somebody came in and I was asking about their pain levels, they might say it was worse since the last session. But yesterday it was better, and today it's about the same. So we can leave it as those few options. And when you sign this chart part, Jane gives you a few different options prior to setting this up, but we can show all of the options, or you can hide some selections as well. We have a few different ways to set this up and in this chart part, which I'm going to take you through in a little bit here. However, what I want to show you now is a more advanced version of this chart part. If we use this for our special tests, what we can do is set up a list of subjects, which are all of our special tests. And then all of the choices are either going to be positive or negative tests. Depending on which ones I choose, this will actually provide me with a narrative. This is our newest feature included in this chart part. So if somebody came in and I decided to do a special test, that was a compression test, and they showed positive results. When I select the compression test, I've created a narrative here. The patient displays a positive result when performing a compression test. If I wanted to do that for a distraction and it was a negative result, Jane starts to build that narrative in full sentence for you. Again, this is for the ones that you select. When you sign off on your chart, it's going to be condensed, just like so, into one sentence for you. So if you're ever reviewing your charts or you're handing your charts off to a third party, they'll see just the narrative. Now to set this up, there's a number of different ways to do it. But to do this, you just go to your staff profile into the same chart templates that you made before. You can create a new template. There's nothing in the template library just yet, but we're hoping that our users will add these and share them so others can use their narratives. If they would like to, the template, new template here, or you can grab an existing one. For now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this existing one, the special tests, and this has our fully built out narrative. But let's start brand new and fresh. Click the add item button. We'll add this to our chart, and here is where I can click on it to edit the options. And we break this down into four different sections, and off the start, you'll see three. The first section here is the label, the choice style, and the displayed the sign note as. The label is the same as your notes and checkboxes and dropdowns now. You can change that label as you go along. The choice style, this is a little newer. You can display your choices as checkbox. You'll see those update down in the background here. Dropdowns, buttons, which you saw earlier, and also sliders. So depending on what you would like to use, you can set your choice style. I really like this new buttons feature. The second one is displaying your notes. How do they want to look when they're signed? Maybe you want to show all of the options. You can do that here. You can show just the selected ones, and then you can build out the narrative. And I'm going to hop into the narrative at the end of this. Sections 2 and 3, they're very similar. Those are your subjects and your choices. Again, your subjects can be anything you would like. You can use a longer term here. Just add the chest. And we have this optional short label. You don't need to use it, but what you'll notice is if these names are getting quite long here and they're taking up a lot of room, you can shorten that label if you'd like to. And very similar with your choices, these choices are all going to show up for the subjects that are listed. And if you wanted to add a short label here, you can do that as well. If you'd like to, you can get quite fancy and use some of the charts here if you wanted to. and you can use some emojis as well. And this will change in your background here. So there we go. This is what it would look like in the background here, the options list, if I were to save it. However, if you do want to use that narrative feature, that is our fourth section here. When you go to select an option, just choose narrative. And the way this works is there's an intro, there's a chunk in the middle, and then there's also an outro. So the intro, you can choose. We often have views the patient as a starting point by default. Then the subject to choice phrasing is the middle section, and this uses your subjects and the choices that you have below. This can be paired with your short label as well. So in Jane will always use the subject title here. So if I said the patient, we'll just change this to the patients, and I want to say arm is worse using that choice, and I'll finish off with this visit. Just like so, I can see how it would appear. The patient's arm is worse during the visit. And then I can scroll on down and click save. And if you wanted to preview or have some default selected options, you can go through and pre-select those or see what it would look like. Before saving, if you don't want any pre-selected choices, just make sure that you go and empty those. You can get into a little bit more complicated and more complex scenarios here if you wanted to. For instance, for our positive and negative choices, when we built our narrative, we added our choices and then the subjects, and we made it so that our subject names here are a little bit longer and they fit in the sentence, and then our short labels are used here. So that's what I'm seeing. That's what we'll see when we're charting. As you're going along, feel free to play around with it. Send us any feedback. We're excited to let this into the wild and hear more from you. We'll talk soon. Take care.